PFC acquired REC yesterday after releasing the payment to the government and the transfer of REC shares to PFC. Timsi Jaipuria caught up with Rajiv Sharma, the chairman and managing director of PFC, earlier and began by asking him whether they plan to merge the two companies' businesses. Listen in.
It is too premature. Today we have closed the deal and we have acquired 52.63% of Government of India stake in REC. It has become our subsidiary today. And we have become a promoter company. The roadmap will be decided in consultation with Government of India.
There were concerns that were raised that this is going to actually weaken PFC's capital adequacy. What are your comments on that, sir?
We were also a little worried whether deal will be closed or not. And there were apprehensions by the rating agencies like Moody and ICRA. They had put us on watch. We were in continuous dialogue with them. We were trying to explain to them that we will be comfortable in our capital adequacy. And I'm happy to inform you, when we close the deal today, this Moody's have retained our earlier BA3 rating with a stable outlook. Similarly, ICRA, CRISIL, and CARE, the three domestic rating agencies, have retained our highest rating of AAA. So all concerns have gone now, and I don't see any problem. My growth in my disbursement is continuing as it was earlier. I'm sure this year we will be able to disburse more. Moreover, to maintain our capital adequacy, we are taking various measures. Like, we have already raised 5,500 crores sub-debt from the market during last week. And during the next financial, we will consider for increasing our tier 1 capital. There are various measures for that. We will explore the possibility as and when time comes.
So how are you funding this deal, to be precise? How much of a debt, how much of an equity? What are the areas from where you are raising, and how will you actually fund the deal?
We have paid 14,500 crores to Government of India today. Shares of Government of India have been transferred to PFC. Out of this 14,500 crores, I can say that majority of it is from our recoveries, because we have a loan book of around 3 lakh crore. So we get our recoveries. So majorly it is through recoveries and some term loans from the banks. During last few months, when there were concerns in the market, we were not raising the domestic bonds. We were getting term loans from the banks at MCLR rates. So to maintain our low cost of capital.
When we talk of the stressed assets, stressed loans that PFC has, there are again some concerns on that. What would you like to clarify on that? How are you going to settle your stressed loans?
I think by acquiring REC, we will be having a uniform approach in resolving stressed assets. Because in most of the private sector projects, PFC, REC, both are consortium partners. Earlier, there was not a uniform approach by REC and PFC. We were taking divergent views. Once REC has become my subsidiary, we will have a uniform approach. We will have discussions pre-lenders meet, and we will have a common approach for resolving those assets. And in this direction, we have already resolved one asset, Ratli Hydroelectric Project of GVK. For last 11 months, they have been paying to us regularly, and we will be able to restore for 600 crores provisioning this quarter, Q4. So on other stressed assets, we are at various stages of resolution. So I am quite hopeful that once Honorable Supreme Court announces the judgment on 12th February circular, we will further get the way forward for resolving these stressed assets. But outside NCLT, we are making sincere efforts with other consortium partners to resolve stressed assets.
So when we talk of the merged entity, what is the way forward when it comes to the future business plans? What are your big proposals that the merged entity will now be looking at as a forward-looking? What is the way forward?
on consolidation basis, if we see, we will be having about 6 lakh crore loan asset book. We will be having around 50,000 crores income and around 11,000 crores profit on consolidation basis. And this will be the third highest profit-making public sector undertaking in the country after ONGC and IOC. And in financial space, this will be one of the largest financial institutions. So it will be a dominant player. It will be a one-stop shop for all comprehensive funding of power sector. It will be helping in implementation of various flagship schemes and initiatives of Government of India for restoring financial viability of state power utilities and to strengthen their sub-transmission and distribution system so that they are able to reduce their aggregate technical and commercial losses.